What do you mean that's far enough? I see the yellow tape. I don't want to talk about my day. Oh, is this only for people who live here? This little area right here? Gotcha.
If you want to film stuff, by all means, just come back here.
The tape goes all the way around that yard over there. We got some number markers out in the street, like maybe like bullet casings, you know? And then there's some visual shielding. So I think, yeah. And that the truck that is rolled up at an angle there, I'm guessing that's official and not crashed. So, kind of looks like a shooting to me. Shout out to Contigo for making an excellent product and then upgrading it or whatever so that the gasket on the newer caps just randomly slips off. And so it's one job to hold the coffee in, it fails at. Just by screwing the lid off, you can unseat the gasket that makes the lid seal. And you won't even know that you did it until your coffee starts pouring out. Thanks, Contigo. Contigo. There's a U of A PD car coming off of the campus down there. And yeah, they turned left and kept going. Like, I didn't figure they would be coming to join this. crosswalk online. I get it about the walkway too. Like I'm not gonna push that because if they closed this off, like if they put the tape to actually mark the walkway for people to get in and out of the building, then technically every time they let someone in, they would have to log that because they're inside the crime scene that's defined by the tape. So as you can see, I am being understanding about that and not just being like, well, there's the tape, I'm gonna walk over there, yada, yada, yada. So they just manually, you know, tell people not to like hang out in there. It's whatever, it's a gray area, but you gotta give people some slack. And it's always good for me to generate some evidence that I'm not an asshole to balance the rest of it. morning. What can you say about what's happening?
Good.
didn't see the second camera. Probably in the edge of their shot. The woman there definitely keeps looking at me. She's like, damn it, someone has a cell phone. There goes my job. And they're all nice and polite. They do their thing on the corner across from where the tape is marked out. It's just common decency not to come right up to the tape. Security guard just walked by and said something to the cop about, what, 4 hours later? So I think they've been here for a while. What I don't understand is why the police aren't over on that corner by that camera and the nice light saying, is this someone's property? Whose camera is this? I wouldn't want this to just be abandoned.
Is anyone's bag? You know, you've been recording. Can you just don't get right up in my face, sir?
Don't get right up in my bag, sir.
Is this your bag? Okay. I didn't want somebody's abandoned bag to be here. That's all.
Sure.
Okay.
You know, when that woman walked over there, I thought they were maybe gonna... I thought she was... You know, I thought potentially she was going to say something about me to the other people. And then I was like, well, why? Like, what would she say? She's just waving at me. Like, what is the point of that? And then they didn't look over here. And I thought, well, okay, maybe I was wrong. And then, when I wasn't looking... out of the corner of my eye, I saw that they did look over here. And then she comes across and waves.
Hello, how you doing?
And I just don't feel like talking because I'm kind of in the middle of narrating this to you, so I don't really know where these people are coming from. And also, I didn't feel like he was really genuine. I mean, maybe I'm judgmental. Also, couldn't immediately understand what his reasoning would be for saying, "Hello, how you doing?" to me from across the street. Just weird, right? That's just weird. I think it's kind of suspicious. I think the police should be investigating. Yeah, and if this has been going on for 4 hours, at least, it could go on for 4 more, easily. I'm not gonna, that's for sure. Is this somebody's light? I'd hate for there to be an abandoned light here. This is a really serious incident, and I get it that there's a lot to do. And I still can't help getting the impression that a lot of people are here not doing anything. And also, of course, there's going to be, man, this guy just cannot help looking at me. There's going to be, which also situational awareness, I understand that, but I'm not sure if that's it. There's going to be a need for excess, especially around something like this, a violent shooting. There's going to be a need for extra eyes and kind of like empty capacity. So in case anything else happens, like if somebody was going to come back or whatever, just to deal with the public or, you know, in case if anything else comes up, you know, you want to have some extra people around. Sure. Just saying that, you know, without like being aware that I might have a bias, I might be looking for wastefulness because I want to point that out. I want it to be clear how much that's going on. I want there to be accountability. I want to know that, the exorbitant amounts of money that we spend on the police department are being used well. And I know they're not, you know, I know they're not. So I do have a bias, but, you know, like to temper that with some reality, some pragmatism. Like, of course you need a lot of people to handle a scene like this. And as I've been here for an hour, just about, I now have the impression that a lot of these people really are idle. A lot of them are doing stuff and they do it at their pace, and especially with the detective aspect of this, you know, looking for those shell casings and whatever other clues, you have to be slow and methodical. And so you see people walking around, they're not, you know, it's not like they're pumping out fast food. They don't need a sense of urgency. I mean, they should have some degree of, like, I'm not sure they do, like, they have some degree of let's get this done, but they're also moving slowly and coordinating with each other. So they're standing around talking. That's obviously going to be part of the job. But my gosh, it is a lot of people and a lot of standing and a lot of talking and a lot of extra capacity. You know, just the 2, 3, 4 patrol officers at, like, standing around the perimeter. And that's, you know, you want to be able to talk to people and tell them they can't cross the police line. You have to maintain the purity, the sanctity. Wait, I'm trying not to sound religious about this. You have to maintain the scene so that people don't come, just like when you're not looking, you know, turn your back and they step in and, you know, kick a bullet shell casing. Just saying. Lots of people.
Thank you.
Morning.
What happened here?
All signs point to shooting.
That is just, what is the fucking matter with people?
That's a great question. Something's definitely the matter with somebody, with both sides in this case, because one of them died.
So I just moved here, honestly, like a week ago to Tucson.
Mm-hmm.
I've been seeing a lot of stuff like online. Is crime like a problem in this area? Pretty high. Like,
I mean, this kind of thing is not common. You know, I've been here for a few years, and I just was getting coffee and walked into this, and it's not that common at all. I mean, not to this level. I mean, there's a lot of little crime. You know, there's a lot of.
This is right on the campus, though.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is not a good look for UA.
Yeah. And again, it's really not, especially like on campus. I mean, there's always crime. There's regularly like one-on-one assault kind of stuff.
Yeah, but
and
this does not look good for their private university. I mean, no one wants to send their kid to a private university that has shootouts on it.
Yeah. Well, it's a public university. Like, it's a state university. Yeah. But I mean, where are you going to go where somebody doesn't get shot every now and then, you know?
Well, in Arizona, other state universities in Arizona, not really.
Yeah, I mean, there's Northern Arizona University and Arizona State in Phoenix. I think it's in Phoenix. I feel like I should know that, but I'm not actually sure. But yeah, there's other places. All right, take care. Welcome to Tucson. Okay, I have no idea when it stopped recording, but I think it did. So, damn it, what is this world coming to?